I think, gentlemen, I know you're old school. Like me, I'm old school, but I spent a lot of time doing play-by-play of minor league hockey, 14-year-olds, that kind of thing. And so my judgment when it comes to the violence in hockey may be a little different than the regular hockey fan. So my heart goes out, just like those animals, it goes out to the players, and my heart goes out to Carl Eller. He's the only guy I like on Montreal. That was a dirty hit, and the reason it's a dirty hit is because he didn't control what he was doing. He should have done his best to avoid his head. He didn't.
He did. He didn't hit his head.
Well,
he didn't. He hit his shoulder.
We'll show
have
you
a look at it again, Frank. He didn't.
Yeah. If you're watching, we'll show you the highlights here as we go through them. But I agree. I think that guy got a suicide pass and certainly smashed his face.
It's a shame. It's awful to see what happened. I mean, no one likes to see that.
No.
But that was a clean hit. And
oh, you guys are saying that he broke his nose and the damage done was when he hit the ice.
Hit the ice.
Yeah.
And lost his teeth.
But he was out cold. Before he hit the ice. That looked to me like he was out cold before he hit the ice.
Have a look at it again, though. He never hit his head. It did not hit his head. It was a shoulder-to-shoulder hit. It was a vicious hit, and I couldn't agree with you more on that. But the way we see the game, that was not aimed at the head. So I thought the penalty was too much, and frankly, 5 minutes for interference. It wasn't interference. The puck was on his stick.
To be honest with you, Frank, I'd give a month's mortgage if I could just catch Bill like that come with his head down as he walks in the door in the morning.
I get that impression.
Frank, thanks for calling.
You're welcome.
Call us again.
Take care, yeah.
Bye.
Well, you know what? And for what Frank says, a lot of people agree with him that that it was a dirty hit. I saw Paul McLean, the Ottawa coach, said afterwards, if there's anyone to blame, it's Rafael Diaz. The pass was a suicide pass. And I hate seeing guys down like that.
And even Diaz was interviewed after the game, and he says, I feel so bad. I saw him open for a second. I just threw it up to him, and then I thought, hey!
Yeah, well, but the worst part about this is, the fact that the league is looking at it is really a danger. I have to believe that they're not going to give him any more than what he got last night. Because, frankly, it wasn't a penalty. And it could have cost the Ottawa Senators game one in the series for a good play. I'm sorry, but no one likes to see anyone get hurt like that. That's just not – that no one wants to see that. And I feel bad for Eller. And I hope that Eller comes back, but I would suggest Montreal will lose him for a little bit. But I'm sorry. That's part it's almost as if he got a knee injury in the sense that in the playing of the game, sometimes you get hurt.
Certainly is one of the stories, and there were a lot of big hits in this game. Subban started it all off with a big hit against Chris Neal of all people, really got the crowd into it.
And again, if you're going to call the one a penalty, then that was a penalty.
Exciting,
there you go.
Exciting
you know?
Game for sure.
That was called a penalty because he got hurt.
Yeah.
That's what it was, and that was the referees. And I've been railing against the referees in the NHL for this entire year. They called that penalty because the fans demanded it.
It's Daguerre nowadays. You're going to get called every time on it. Listen.